I worked really, really hard on my vows. But, you know, now that we're here, look, hey, do you remember the last time that we were here? Standing right around in this spot, it was right in the beginning, before we really knew each other. I was trying to get away from you because you were irritating me. And you chased me down and you caught up to me. I said to you, listen, I just have to get all my ducks in a row. Right? And then you said to me,
I can be a duck.
Ducks up in a row, I can maybe a competitor.
I don't know what that means, but I think I could be a duck.
Not a duck.
Yeah. You know, we had been chasing each other
right from the beginning.
Time.
Your evidence is anecdotal.
I'm that guy. Bones, I'm that guy. I know.
I missed my chance.
Chasing each other through wars.
1 year from today. And
serial killers.
Sweetie.
Ghosts.
Sorry.
It's okay to be sad, Temperance. It's okay to cry. It's all right.
It is sad.
And snakes.
What are you doing? They're not poisonous.
I know! I know!
Why don't you come down?
It seems I'm not completely in control of my actions.
Just get on my back.
Oh. What the hell was that?
Come on, let's go, huh? Chop, chop.
Chasing you has been the smartest thing that I have ever done in my life. And being chased by you has been my greatest joy. But now we don't have to chase each other anymore because we caught each other.
When Hodgins and I were buried alive, we each wrote a message to someone we loved in case our bodies were ever found.
Anyone you want to say goodbye to?
Hodgins wrote to Angela, and I wrote to you. Dear Agent Booth, you are a confusing man. You are irrational and impulsive, superstitious and exasperating.
Fish.
You're a superstitious moron. You believe in ghosts and angels and maybe even Santa Claus. And because of you, I've started to see the universe differently.
One thing for me to do is to keep on trying to get home to you.
How is it possible that simply looking into your fine face gives me so much joy? Why does it make me so happy that every time I try to sneak a peek at you, you're already looking at me? Like you, it makes no sense. And like you, it feels right. If I ever get out of here, I will find a time and a place to tell you that you make my life messy and confusing and unfocused and irrational and wonderful. This is that time. This is that place. Did I do that wrong?
No.
Oh.
By the powers vested in me by the District of Columbia and the Internet, I now pronounce you man and wife.